Today I'll be going through examples of counting chromosomes, chromatids, and ploidy during meiosis and mitosis. Make sure that you're already familiar with each stage of meiosis and mitosis before you watch this video. Some concepts you should be familiar with is that one, a chromosome can have one or two chromatids, depending on the stage of meiosis or mitosis that the cell is in. And two, the cell may be haploid or diploid, also depending on the stage that the cell is in. Also, it's important to note here that haploid and diploid numbers are characteristics of the species. Next, I wanted to go through an equation that is often used in problems and what this can tell you when solving a problem. On one side of the equation, you'll have the ploidy, which refers to if the cell is haploid or diploid. In the case of n equals 8, the cell is haploid, which we know because it has n and not 2n. And on the other side of the equation, this is the amount of chromosomes in the cell. And the number of chromosomes is counted by the centromeres. So this equation means that when a cell is haploid, then it will have 8 chromosomes. Now, you can also have an equation like this when the cell is diploid, and it'll look like this. 2n equals 16. And this means that when the cell is diploid, then the cell will have 16 chromosomes. And you can also convert from the diploid number to the haploid number by dividing both sides by 2, and you'll get that n equals 8. Now, let's look at an example problem, which asks, if a cell has 16 DNA molecules and the cell is in metaphase, then what is n? We know this question is asking about metaphase of mitosis because if it was metaphase of meiosis, then it would have a Roman numeral next to it and it would look like this, either metaphase 1 or metaphase 2. And there are two things to keep in mind about metaphase of mitosis. The first is that there are 2 chromatids per 1 chromosome. And the second is that the cell is diploid. And the cell being diploid means that there are 2 of each type of chromosome. So 2 of chromosome 1, 2 of chromosome 2, 2 of chromosome 3, and 2 of chromosome 4. And as you can see, I've drawn out this picture so that it's easier to visualize what's happening in the cell during metaphase of mitosis. So because we know that the cell is diploid, then that means that we have the ploidy side of the equation. So we can go ahead and write 2n equals. And remember, the other side will be the number of chromosomes in the cell. And we can find that by using the information given to us that there are 16 DNA molecules, which is the same as saying 16 chromatids. And we can convert from chromatids to chromosomes by using this ratio of 2 chromatids per 1 chromosome. And you put the chromatids on the bottom of the fraction here so that the units of chromatids can cancel out. So you'll end up dividing by 2 chromatids to get 8 chromosomes. And so you can now see that 2n equals 8 because you just found that there are 8 chromosomes in the cell. So in order to isolate for n, the haploid number, you can divide both sides of this equation by 2 to get n equals 4. And for the next example, a question asks, if a species has a diploid number of 18, then how many DNA molecules and chromosomes does a cell have in prophase 2? So first, we should remember that in prophase 2, the cell is haploid, and we can find the number of chromosomes by using what is given to us, that 2n equals 18, because the diploid number is 18, and divide by 2 on both sides and solve for n, which equals 9. So therefore, there are 9 chromosomes in the cell, and we can draw this out. You can find the number of DNA molecules by remembering that there are 2 chromatids per chromosome because the homologous pairs have just separated in meiosis 1, but the sister chromatids are still intact. And because we just found that there are 9 chromosomes, we can go ahead and set up this dimensional analysis again and multiply 9 chromosomes by 2 chromatids, and the units of chromosomes will cancel and you'll be left with 18 chromatids, which is the correct answer.